to our discussion today. We want to talk a little bit about a campaign called Twende Mosmos Tufike Salama and just touch on matters to do with road safety. Joining me in studio, I'll start from the fire right there, is Habib, brother to the late Issa. I asked for his government name and he told me it is Habib. We leave it at that. Next to him, at least his government name, I know, David Mathenge, also known as Nameless. And next to me is Wangeshi Mwangi, also known as Wangeshi. Wangeshi Waweru.
Yes.
Okay. There's a mistake on some online. I'll find that site and send it to you. And each of them are here to share their experiences in terms of road safety. Two of them have gone through harrowing incidents. You were touched and your life was changed by an incident that Nameless was involved in. But maybe let's start with the Twende Mosmos Tufike Salama campaign. At least let's make sure our viewers know what's going on with start with you. Tell us about this campaign.
Well, this campaign is actually, I thought about it 3 years ago. And I approached Nameless like a year ago, and I had this idea whereby I wanted to honor Issa and road accident victims. And I thought that this song Mosmos was actually putting out that message whereby we should reduce speed while we're driving, mm-hmm. to avoid accidents. And not only that, there's so many other things that are attached to it. Not only speed, but also driving under the influence, and also taking safety measures like putting on safety belts and all that. So we sat down with him, and I told him the idea. And we began looking for a team whereby we can raise awareness to a level whereby we can get to everybody in Kenya,
okay.
Like everyone in Kenya who lives in Kenya, and preferably the whole world.
So has the campaign been launched?
It's being launched today.
Or today?
Now it's actually happening. So after this, we're supposed to join our team at Machakos Country Bus.
Okay.
Yes.
Nameless, tell us about the activities Kenyans or Nairobians can expect, those who will be at the Machakos Country Bus later today.
The important thing is to get the message out about safety. And of course, we thought, where is the best place to start? And when's the best time to start, which would be Easter, because a lot of traveling happening then. Mm-hmm. And you can imagine one driver with 50 people, mm-hmm. passengers. If he makes a mistake, he can affect 50 families. So it's all about, there'll be things like pledges. In fact, we want to make these guys, you know, take a pledge. How they're going to be drive safe, mm-hmm. and what they're going to do to be safe.
Mm-hmm.
Talk about all the safety measures. We're musicians, so we'll also have to, you know, hold a mic and, you know, tell guys, everywhere you go, we'll be told, sawa, imba wewe, nini wewe. So there'll also be a bit of entertainment, but in this case, will just be used to first bring attention, so that now the message, the most important thing today is bringing out the message of safety.
Briefly, do you have like a 1 year plan, 6 month plan, or 5 year plan?
There's definitely a plan.
What's the future like for this campaign?
We're going to go, we start off now, but we're definitely going to go around the country, tour around the country, the main hotspots,
okay.
Main towns. And then we're going to look for different things in terms of going to hospitals also, so we can get testimonials. In fact, we're just talking about spinal injury and where you can find people who will give that story. Because the problem we realize is people don't think it will happen to them. You know, when you're there, you feel like, it's not cool to wear a safety belt. You know, it won't happen to me.
It happens to other people.
It happens to other people, yeah. Mm. So showing people what can happen. If you don't take care, we're going to do all those kind of things. We're talking about documentaries and stuff like that. So there are very many things that that we are planning along the way. And it will end up being a foundation, of course.
Mm-hmm.
The ISA Foundation, Road Safety Mosmos Foundation.
And of course, I've seen you've got some sort of partnerships with the Red Cross. And
And what's happening as we started off, and then we want more people. Because there are very many companies, honestly, that have a passion about road safety. Looking for who can help us push the message. Yeah.
Okay.
So we're going to start it off and then welcome people to come in and support the message.
Well, Wangeshi, this obviously must be a topic that is close to your heart, bearing in mind you went through a particularly harrowing accident a couple of years back.
Yeah.
If you can briefly share what happened for the benefit of some of our viewers who may not remember or hadn't, you know, gotten to know about that, but also how it changed your view about road safety. What was your perception about
safety before
and after?
Well, the incident happened in 2014. It's been 4 years. I was even shocked that it was 4 years.
It's been 4 years now.
We were coming back from a birthday party with my three friends, and we ended up in a road accident. Weirdly enough, I woke up in the hospital, so I don't have full recollection
my
of
goodness.
What happened.
Mm.
But I lost a friend, my best friend, who was seated with me in the back. And ever since then, the recovery process, the first three months were hard. But then now, as you can see, I'm back to full working and programming. And what I'd like to say about what I thought about road safety before and what I think about it now. Before, as Nameless was saying, you think this thing can't happen to me. I'm Wangeshi. Wangeshi didn't get into road accidents.
Mm.
I always put on my safety belt. Everything happens. And the actual thing that happened was the safety belt is what saved me.
The safety belt is what
right
saved
now
you.
I wouldn't be here if I had my safety belt
mm-hmm.
on. So it's more of education of knowing, as in safety belt, it has to be your first thing you put when you enter into the car. It has to be the safety belt. Because that's your savior at that point.
My English is failing me. How more aware are you of the perceptions that young people have towards road safety? What do people tell you after the? I'm sure you give them warning.
Wow, young people are hard to teach. Because right
you
now we're
like
there.
Someone's parent.
I'm my friend's parent. Because right now we're in the high.
Yeah,
in the high,
yeah,
then
yeah,
I'm in university.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's go out. Let's go to Westie, whichever new club has come up.
Mm.
It's so hard. Like even my. I got into an accident, guys.
Mm.
But you can still hear stories of, hey, you guys, Jana, we were so late.
Mm.
Who was driving? They're still the same guys who were driving and everything. And the weirdest thing is, like a month ago, we were going through pictures with my friends of past times. And we realized three of the people in those pictures have already passed on from road accidents.
Really?
People that I know. One person being hit by a matatu guy, two of them, it's, what's it called, under the influence.
Driving, or something of the sort.
Yeah,
okay.
Right.
So it's touched quite a bit on friends that you have in your circles and
exactly.
My Habib, coming back to you.
Yes.
This for you is an appropriate way to honor Issa. What do you hope to see as the end game? So you're telling us what you're doing now. What do you hope it will lead to? What are some of the goals as you put your project together or
okay.
this campaign together?
There's something my mom tells me, and in Swahili she says, "Hawezi kununua uhai." So basically, what we are trying to do is save lives and reduce the number of road accidents. As you saw, the past year, December, we lost so many people.
It was unbelievable.
It was tragic.
Mm.
And it wasn't a bomb. It wasn't anything. It was road accidents.
Mm.
Yeah, something that we could avoid if we only listened and paid attention to road safety.
Mm-hmm. What do you think is the biggest issue that causes these accidents that we see on our roads? I guess you now have a personal interest because of what happened.
I believe it's ignorance.
Not
ignorance
mm-hmm.
on our part and also on those are put there to stop such things. I'm talking about, I don't want to mention them.
You don't want to get in trouble.
I don't want to get into trouble, but we are all responsible. And it's up to us. You know, to take that initiative and be serious about it and talk about it and actually put
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I think just to add to that,
go ahead.
I think that because there are many things that cause accidents, driving and influence, speed and all that. But when I look at it, because I was also involved in an accident, and when I really rethink about it, I'm like 20 kilometers slower, it wouldn't have happened because why the accident happened was just for a short while we looked at a lake Elementaita, all of us. Issa is one of us. Oh, ah, that lake looks beautiful. And we looked, all of us, you know, including the driver, just looked.
Mm.
So there were no other cars. But then just because of looking, you know, the car begins to sway.
Kind of
so now you,
lane.
Yeah, so now you're like, you're losing, you know, you're veering. So you try push it back. And then now you try put it back again, and you know, then you roll. So you can imagine if it was maybe 20 kilometers slower.
You're unable to control the car.
Control many things. You can be sober, and the other guy's drunk.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're driving fast and he does something, you can get yourself back in control. So the first thing is, you know, fast speed. Just go at the speed you will get there. That's why. And the most to fikia salama.
Mm.
You get there, whatever the case. You'd rather get there.
How has your routine? In fact, it's interesting you've said that. So you do shows all over. Country,
mm-hmm.
You might be in Nairobi at 6 p.m. and you need it in Nakuru at 9
yeah,
p.m. Kisi,
yeah,
I mean everywhere,
yeah.
And I see your flyers all the time.
Yes.
How have you changed the way you operate because of what happened to you? Do you now tell event organizers, I'm sorry,
yeah.
I'm going to be five hours late to get to your gig because I'm not gonna speak. Talk about lifestyle change.
The reality is, even when you're booking shows, you can see what can I achieve and what can I not achieve. Mm. You know, you can get bookings at the same time. You're like, what? And then you guys talk about it, and I'm like, what, dude, are you going to pull that off? He's like, I have a show here, and then I'm going to rush to Meru, and that show, you know, and you're like, dude, is it worth it? You know, is it worth that risk? So initially, from the time you're booking, just book enough that you can handle, you know? And then when you're there, and there are times you might be late, you'd rather be late than not make it. So if you're getting late, as you say, which I feel is most important to do, tell the promoter, early enough, listen, a bit late. Mm. Plan yourselves with your program so that I reach late, as opposed to lying and trying to drive fast and then something happens.
You're chasing money.
Because you're chasing money and stuff like that. So in the end of the day, your life must be the first thing you're thinking about.
Okay.
The hustle comes later. You can't, without life, you
can't
hustle.
You have to be
hustle.
Alive, exactly. I guess you really laughed when I asked.
About to be driving slow for a gig.
Yes. Arriving late to, you know, to save a life, so to speak. Yeah, let me get your thoughts. And I guess also your concerns now. In the past, I guess, and for those who may not have been involved in a major accident, when you hear about accidents on TV, it's a statistic about those there.
Mm.
How do you now feel when you hear on this road, on that road? Has it changed the way you receive such information? Is it now, I guess, more real to you?
Of course, it takes you back to also being in that same position. And you think about how everybody was affected around it. Because when you're in an accident, it's not just you who's in the accident. It's your mom, it's your brother, mm-hmm. it's your friends who are all in that accident. Everybody's in
you.
That thing at the same time. So as I hear that, I'm listening to the guys who are affected, the parents, everybody around that whole situation. So, of course, it always draws me back to where I was at that same time, yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Habib, also same to you, the same question I asked Nameless. Behavior change, what measures have you put in place? Young people are watching and asking and thinking, okay, you've told us what to do. What changes did you make in your life after what happened to Issa?
Well, first of all, I'm always sober when I'm driving. I don't take that risk.
It's important you talk to us a bit about that, because that's one issue that has been raised.
Soberness is one thing. And if you think you cannot drive, I think if you think you cannot drive or you're not able to drive, you should take a taxi or something.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as in put yourself first, you know. Mm. Take care of yourself. Think about your family, as she said. Think about the people who will be affected.
Mm-hmm.
And also, you know, you can't buy life. You only have one life to live. So why waste it? So when I'm on the road, I'm always thinking about other cars, my car. Yeah? And that's what my mom will always tell me. Chunga gari yako kwanza. Usiseme ati huu mwingine ana makosa. Sijui nini. Wewe chunga gari yako. Kwa hivyo ukijichunga, pia unachunga watu wengine.
Okay. Nameless, this weekend, starting today actually, we know, and it's good you've chosen Machakos bus station, because a lot of Kenyans will be heading up country or to different destinations in matatus.
Yeah.
You're talking to the drivers. Talk to
and
me
the
about
passengers. We're talking
the
about
passengers as well, and what messages you're going to give them.
Yeah, I mean, of course the drivers, we're making them understand that, and our role also being there, we have been in accidents. So we're like, listen, you know, this ice has affected us, so you need to be careful about that. And passengers also telling them, you know, if you're in a matatu or a bus that's going very fast, you actually have a right to say, slow them down, because it's your life in the end of the day. You're talking about behavior change. I remember me after the accidents, safety belt, like, it's ridiculous how it became so in me that I would enter a movie theater and the first reaction I have is like that's when I knew this is in my system. This is good, you know? I just feel every time I would sit somewhere, feel, okay, we're about to get into something, so just first buckle up, you know? So that was straight behavior change.
That's
because
hilarious.
You're like, no, because you're like, you know what, me, I'm not dying. I don't want to die anytime now, you know? So we are still hoping to see whether we can still pull off Nakuru within the same weekend.
Okay.
And we're still debating on that as one of the spots that we want to go and talk to guys, probably on Sunday or something. But now we'll find out about that. But so we're going to talk to people about that, about especially drivers and passengers, that both people, you're responsible for how things happen in that vehicle, you know? Yeah, so that's messaging that we are pushing.
Be responsible. I want to give each of you a chance to make a final comment. Yeah. Each of you are artists, so you don't fear the cameras. You deal with them almost every day.
Yeah.
I don't know which camera belongs to who. Angeshi, I think that one's yours. Right. So everyone will do it on three. We'll start with you, Angeshi, Habib, and then Nameless. Just say something, last word to Kenyans who are watching. And if you have, you can drop it in if you also want to as well.
Aisha had arrived. You told me I had a prepared one. I'm really good at that. But anyway, my message to Kenyans out there, especially to the youth, because I think I'm the closest to your ages.
Mm-hmm.
If you have to go out, guys, there's Uber, there's taxi. Okay, I don't want to advertise them. There are taxis out there. Taxi, or keep your car somewhere and find another friend who's sober and go home with them. Your life isn't worth that one night out. Mm-hmm. Sawa.
Important message, Habib. Okay. You can use the same camera three. What's your message?
My message basically is the message that we're all putting out there. Twende Mosmos, tufike salama. One thing I wanted to add, today we're going to make people take oaths, whereby they're going to be swearing not to drink and drive.
I was going to ask which
put
oath.
On belts.
We had a problem with an oath the other day.
No.
Okay, now this is
safety. Put human life first,
okay.
You know, first in everything. So the people will be approaching, the drivers and all of them, pedestrians, Samaritans, they're going to take oaths. Whereby now they'll be forced to do what they've
comply by that oath.
Yeah,
since you
comply by that,
you've said it yourself, and not forced to do so.
Yeah.
Nameless, I'm told yours is camera two.
Camera two.
Okay.
Oh, kila mtu na kamera yake.
Kila mtu na.
For me, I think that many people know that I was in an accident that we lost Isa, and I really just want people to know right now that. When every time I meet guys, they always ask me, hey, can you imagine if Issa was here,
yes.
Still alive, 15 years, you know, all this time. Habib is here, he'll tell you about losing a brother, losing a son, you know, and stuff like that, because of a fraction of a second, you know. So, as we said, it can happen to anybody. There's no one that the accidents, discriminate. It can happen to everyone. Please, when you get into a car, put on your safety belt. That's the first thing you're in control of. Yeah, ensure that you put a safety belt on, just so to protect yourself from anything that might happen. Secondly, please drive mosmos ufike salama. Thirdly, do not drink and drive. It is not worth it. There are many taxis, many options. Fourthly, have a beautiful Easter. Enjoy yourselves.